Okay, I'm back. I'm sorry with part two, and I'm going to lift this up for Lindy because she wanted to say something.
Yeah, I was going to say something. I don't know if all of you out there have seen his face, but you were talking about reptilian creatures or whatever.
Yeah, they were male and female, but when they got out of this pyramid, he was saying they didn't, excuse me, when they came out of the pyramid, they didn't look like celebrities, but there was a couple celebrities, some unknown people.
Who do you know that we've seen lately on TV that does not look human?
I know who you're gonna, I know who you're talking about, but I don't know his name, and I don't want to get into that on here.
I do know his name.
Yeah, but I don't want it said on here because
I'll just do the initials. Can I do the initials?
Yeah, I'd rather you didn't because some people get upset to make it offended. But we're not talking about Obama.
He does not look human in any kind of way.
No, he doesn't. He doesn't. And no, when I saw him on TV and not just a picture, like when he was talking and moving around, yeah.
Can I just say he's out of Florida.
Okay, that's yeah. And we'll just
out of Florida, and you can figure it out. It's been in the news lately.
Well, watch it. You know,
I just said out of Florida.
Yeah, but I asked you just not to do that.
Okay.
These people can figure crap out for themselves. We have very intelligent customers who.
Well, I know, but I'm saying
do know what's going on.
Okay. Okay. Sorry.
Okay. So anyway, the being that had whispered to him did not look like a reptilian, but it wasn't male or female. Now later on he finds out, because a few moments later, like, there's screaming.
Oh wow.
Yeah, he hears screaming and he figures out that this thing is some kind of captive and it broke free long enough to give him something that he could use against these beings. But he could use it against the beings before they started doing what they were doing, like kind of like shifting time.
Right.
Because they're able to, see, here's the thing, these beings, he later found out because he did another trip to the archives. Now the Vatican knows that this stuff is going on and these beings are able to shift time. They can shift time. So the problem is when you have somebody that can end the evil that they're doing, all they do is go back and shift time again and stop them from doing it. The piece you're looking at here prevents that, but there's more to this piece though. Okay. So anyway, so I told you, okay, so this being, that was decent was either male or female and it was a captive. Now, he saw this being again. After he had the ownership to the ring, and he was told someone would come for it using terror and to let them have it, not to fight it. So the person or people coming for the ring, he was told to go ahead and let them have it. Don't fight for it. Just go ahead and have them do it. Then a few days later, he was robbed and the ring was sold for gold weight. So they didn't even know what the ring was. They're just like selling it for the weight of the gold, you know, at a pawn shop, I'm assuming. I never asked them that. I need to find out. And then it moved a few more times, but he always knew where it was by those in the jewelry business until I came to it. Now, the guy then came to me in my dreams, woke me up, was with me physically, and told me to tell a story and to make sure people knew what it did. What does it do and what is it? So anyway, this is a first class relic ring. It's 14 karat gold. It is what they call the Christ coral. Some people refer to it as Christ coral. Other people just call it peach coral. It holds the Christ power, the God power.
Flesh tone.
Fighting and immortality. Now, here's the thing with it. This is what's inside of it. And it is hidden very well. And you are more than welcome when you get it to take it to a jeweler. I will not mess with the seal. Should you break the seal on it, okay, that's on you. You have really knocked the value of the ring down. Now, the part that's right there, that's not the seal. The seal is a wax seal. I believe that was put there, what you're looking at underneath the ring, to protect the wax seal. Now, since this ring is very old and it is an antique, if you were to pull that off, are you also going to pull the wax? I don't know. Now, as I understand what is in it is a real thorn that sat on Christ's head with the blood on it. And what else is in that is not just that, but one other saint, I'm not going to say that Jesus was saint, but a saint is in there, which is supposed to be Michael and Gabriel. So you have two bones when they stood and walked as humans, those two bones. So now we're talking three first-class relics. The fourth relic that is supposed to be in there, and I do believe it is because I looked so hard with the magnifier and everything, plus you can feel power coming out of this ring. But Dad, did you pick this ring up? Did you feel the power in this ring?
I felt it when you gave it to me to pass on to
Lindy.
It was pure power.
Yeah, I gave it to him to pass on to Lindy because why did I give it to you? What were you doing with it? I forgot.
Admiring it.
Oh, okay, that. All right. Yeah. But now,
can I ask you something?
Wait a minute. I got to tell them the last relic that's in it because this is one that no one will ever get.
Okay.
Okay. People can get relics of saints. They can get.
That's true.
They can get a relic of the crown of Christ. They'll pay thousands for it, but you can get it.
Right.
But the thing is I'm going to give you history on relics in a minute, but here's the fourth relic that's in there. Now, this guy told me that later on I would be visited by the same being that is held captive by these creatures. And I was. Now, when he was telling me this stuff, when he first appeared to me, okay, you know, I'm awake. I thought it actually was a dead person because sometimes the dead will come and speak to me just as I'm waking up or in the morning because
when
it's
you're
that
calm,
time
yeah.
when I'm very calm and they know like I'm not busy and they are in full physical form. So I just thought it was somebody dead who needed to get a message to a family member in all honesty when he first showed up.
Right.
So, and then he explains everything to me and he told me that another being would come and visit me. And it did. And it was, as he said, neither male nor female, being held captive at this time. But I come to find out he's being held captive because it wants to be. For whatever reason, I believe it's keeping an eye on these things. But the fourth relic in this ring is the bone of God himself. A piece of bone, yes. That's why it felt so funny to you. I'll show you Lynn's face. Because I didn't tell her.
Wow.
Yeah. So that is what's in it. Now, when the being did come to me, the being said that this ring, the two saints that are in it, Michael and Gabriel, the blood of Christ and the bone of God are there because these are going to be the only things that are able to stop these beings from shifting time. And the only reason they're shifting time is to prevent you from killing them. Because you could kill them now and one of their other members shifts time and just brings them back to life. And there's a lot of other stuff that's going to be happening too.
Uh-huh.
That's crazy. I know that this sounds crazy. I understand that it does. But try to imagine that we all don't know everything that goes on. And the longer I live, the more I find stuff out. And you can always say, well, you're told things and you don't know if they're accurate. And that's true. You don't know. But I can tell you this ring is real. When you get it, you can take the back off of it. I'm not breaking the seal.
I guess it
might
be a stupid question.
But he showed it to me anyway. So I do know that it's there. Go ahead.
This may sound silly, but would somebody get something like this? What if they were to take the parts out of here and do like Jurassic Park? You could take.
I thought about that.
You know what I mean?
I do, but you have to have so much blood and so much bone in order to clone.
I don't know that.
I do know it. That's scientific fact. I that I do know.
Because I thought all they have to do is get the tiniest piece of something and it replicates or it
well maybe that is what it's for then.
I'm just saying
I don't
what
know
if, what power would that contain.
Think
I don't about
know.
It if you actually you know having the angels and God himself I mean, of course, you wouldn't duplicate God, not unless he wanted to be.
We'll be right back.